Subscribe to the Vedanta Vision YouTube channel and tap the bell icon. You'll get notified whenever we upload a new inspirational video.
You know, there's a story of a great Mahatma who diligently performed all his spiritual practices, and he was meditating on the banks of a river in the Himalayas. When a hunter came along and shot the mother deer, and the infant, she had just delivered the offspring. So the baby deer was left completely helpless. So this Mahatma, because of all the commotion that took place, he opened his eyes and saw this, the mother dead and the baby lying there. And so he did what anyone would naturally do, which is take care of the infant deer. But in the process, what happened is, he got attached to that deer. So when he was sitting in meditation, instead of thinking of God, he was thinking of the deer. And so they said that what happened is, when he died, he was on the brink of realization. He had no other thought, no other attachment. But he unnecessarily formed an attachment to the deer. So the story goes, he had to go through one extra birth as a deer and exhaust that before he went to realization. Now, if this can happen to a person like that, what must be happening in our minds? This Pandora's box that is there. It's really frightening. And then when things go wrong in our lives, at least that must be taken as a wake-up call. So instead of getting depressed and crying over it and getting, you know, waiting for others to sympathize with you and give you, you know, self-pity and all the rest of it, what the Gita says is, at least have the, all right, you've performed negative actions and the result has come to you. At least have the courage to stand up to it. Don't sit there and get weak-kneed. This is what he's telling Arjuna. Arjuna is faced with a challenge in life, like all of us are faced with challenges. The more you think about, oh, this is my challenge and I'm going under, of course you feel sorry for yourself. But look around you and you see other people facing much greater challenges than you. And when you look at them, you begin to understand that you're blessed because you went through much less drama, much less suffering than many others. And you're grateful for what you've received and you spring back. And you learn from your experiences. You understand that when things go wrong in life, it's because I've thought wrongly in the past, acted wrongly in the past, felt wrongly in the past. Correct that. So these are all wake-up calls, but we don't treat it as a wake-up call. We get further embroiled in the same thing. And that's the problem.